Hi there, welcome back. Let's talk about searching algorithms. So first of all, what is linear search? Linear search is a simple search algorithm that checks every element in the list sequentially until it finds a match or exhausts the list. And what are the properties of linear search? So first of all, linear search does not require sorted data. So this is a very important point. It has a worst case time complexity of O(n), which means that in the worst case scenario, the target element is at the end of the list or not present. The algorithm will have to iterate through every element in the list. For example, let's look at this list here. Let's say we are searching for 55. At the worst case time complexity, it means that we have to search 27, 19, 36, and etc. until we reach end of the list to get 55. So this is the worst case time complexity. And let's say we are just searching for 16 here, it's just gonna be n over 2 here, but we always consider the worst case time complexity. And now let's look at the linear search in Python code for version 1. We have two versions, and later on I will show you the difference between version 1 and version 2. So for this Python code version 1, we have a sample array here. And now let's look at the actual code itself. So this is the definition of linear search. We have two input parameters, which are the array data. So this is the array data here. And then we have the search value, which is the value that we are searching. So for example here, we have a for loop here. For index in range length of array data, it means that for this for loop, we will be looping through every single index inside this loop. For example, we will start from 0 and then 1, 2, 3, 4, until we finish iterating the whole array. And then inside the for loop, we will be just writing a simple if statement. For example here, if array data, let's say we start from 0, if array data 0 is equal to search value, we will just return index. For example, we are searching for the value 100, we will just return 0 as the result, because we found 100 at index 0. And let's say we finish the whole loop and we couldn't find the elements that we are searching for, we will just return negative 1. So this is the full code for linear search. It's actually quite simple. And now let's look at the implementation part. So how do you implement this linear search? So this is the sample here. We'll start from the definition of the array. For example, array data is equal to 100, 5, 1, 15, 98. We are just creating the array as shown above here. And next, search value is equal to integer input, enter the number to search for, and then slash n. So we are just getting the search value using a input prompt. Next will be search value index is equal to linear search bracket array data comma search value. Since we are just getting the index of the search value, therefore, we name the variable as search value index. And the next line will be, if search value index is equal to negative 1, it was not found because we have looped through the whole array and we couldn't find any matching element, we will just return negative 1. Therefore, I will just print it was not found. And let's say the value is not negative 1, we will just print something like this. It was found at index plus string search value index. Since we will be returning integer, therefore I have to add str bracket here. Therefore, the demo will be this one here. Enter the number to search for, we'll just type 15 here, and then the output will be it was found at index 3. So if you look at the example above, because 15 is at index 3, therefore we'll return the value index 3 here. And as a gentle reminder, we have to know that sometimes the question will ask you to use global declare array. It means that for the question that you will see in the exam itself, it will just define a global array first. So you do not have to pass in array data as an input to the linear search function. So you can just modify the code accordingly. For example, for this code here, you can just remove the array data as the input parameter and everything else remains the same. So this is just the general tip. So version 2 is actually very similar to version 1. It's just that instead of returning the index, we will just return the boolean. For example, return true or return false. Let's say we manage to find the elements that we are searching for, we will just return true. And let's say we couldn't find, we will just return false. And the next statement will be this one here. We just have to change the search value index into search value boolean, since we are just returning boolean from the function. So we can just say, if search value boolean is equal to false, it was not found, and let's say it's equal to true, we'll just print it was found. And the demo will be this one here. Enter the number to search for, we'll just input 99. So if you look at the array here, 99 is not inside the array, therefore we'll just output it was not found. So this is the version 2.